Dear students, good afternoon. So I suppose this will be the very last SC questions episode I'm going to record for you. And don't forget that the final exam will cover from the week 2 in December all the way till the first week of January. Okay, so today I'm going to give you 4 questions for January 5th and another 5 questions from yesterday, from January 4th. So question 1 for today. How do you say 日时 and 月时 in English? Question 2. What does eclipse mean in the following sentence?The actor's performance eclipsed all the others in the movie. So what does eclipse mean in this sentence? Question 3. When people say beauty is in the eye of the beholder, what does this person mean? Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. What does it mean? The last question, question 4 in this episode.So we know that the moon is 400 times smaller than the sun, right? But why do the moon and the sun appear to be of similar size in the sky? Why do they appear to be of similar size in the sky? So let's move on to January 4th. Question 1 for January 4th is...How do people call their grandparents or their grandfathers? And what was popsicles originally called? It is related to the person's name who invented popsicle. Question 2. If you are named something, what does it mean? For example, Tokyo is named the world's most satisfying city for travel.So by saying this sentence, what does name mean in this sentence? Question 3. What does in time mean? What does in time mean? For example, in time, Hannah Herbst believes that it will help people without easy access to electricity. In time in this sentence.What does it mean? Question 4. In January 4th InfoCloud, the expression was beacon of hope. So tell me, what is beacon of hope? And can you give me any examples that is beacon of hope? Question 5 is about the vocabulary.So Michelle told us some of the meaning of the prefix 字根. So tell me, what does IN mean in the word infection? And what does FECT mean in this word? And also in the word communication, what does COMMUN mean? Wow, that was a lot.So I hope you enjoy the very last episode of SC Questions. And if time allows, I still hope that you can keep listening to Studio Classroom every day, even though the following episodes might not be covered in our final exam. All right, I'll see you next week. Bye.